Hi everyone, this is Professor Benjamin, and I usually at the end or the beginning of each week I send out a roundup or maybe just some pointers on the readings that you have for the week. So if you haven't already, I hope you have watched this video on the homepage and read the syllabus in detail because this is a quick summer class. So 7 weeks, we cover two sessions a week, so there's a lot of material that you need to cover. And I think it's really important that you spend some time reading the material and processing the information that's given to you in the course. So under the video on the homepage, it tells you the expectations for the course, etc. But we'll cover these two sessions this week. So session one and session two, you have a form here and you'll have another form here. They're both due by Wednesday, 11:59, the initial posts, response posts by Friday. And then it looks like you have a quiz here. You do not have a quiz for Tragedy of the Commons because more of this deals with the readings. There is no real chapter in the textbook that associates with this session. So this session here, you're going to cover the introduction PowerPoint. If you open the PowerPoint in PowerPoint under the slides, there are notes, so that is helpful for you as well. A lot of this information deals with the textbook reading for that chapter, so it's essential that you read that textbook chapter and go over those PowerPoint notes that give you all of the information that you need. I want to spend some time here on this, The Tragedy of Commons by Garrett Hardin. This is a really important article that you need to read for this session. This article seems daunting at first, but when you start to read it, you'll realize what he's trying to get to, the points that Garrett Hardin's trying to get to. One of the biggest things that he's trying to have individuals understand, especially when it comes to the environment, is that technical solutions cannot solve the issue alone. Besides technical solutions, those technical solutions need an extension in morality. And what he means by that is that there needs to be some sort of moral component to it as well, whether that's education or teaching people what the consequences of their action are, all of that kind of stuff. So in this article, you'll read all the different technical solutions that have been proposed to solve Tragedy of the Commons, which is how we destroy shared spaces. That means how we pollute the air or contaminate the water. You know, one of the biggest things now is plastic waste and how much this is polluting our waterways, our ocean waterways, etc. And so those technical solutions, like coming up with some sort of mechanism to clean the oceans, that's all great and all, but it doesn't stop us from producing or using single-use plastic items because we don't understand that we think we're one person, but when you have 7 billion people on the earth, if everyone's using single-use plastic, that by creating, you know, things to clean our ocean or mechanisms to clean our ocean, it doesn't solve the problem that's at heart, which is education, educating people that we need to stop using single-use plastic, whether that's bags or straws or plastic cups, all of that stuff. So he talks about that. So all these technical solutions need that extension in morality. So he talks about mutual corrosion, how mutual corrosion works, which is how we fine people, and he talks about parking meters in there. But it doesn't solve the problem, which is the fact that we just can't seem to understand that if we park our car somewhere and leave it there for days on end, that other people can't use that spot. He talks about the erosion of national parks. He talks about, so all of these are technical solutions that we've put into place where we put government in charge or we charge people to enter places. He talks about the welfare state, that in order to stop commons use, we've put welfare into use, which I'm not against. I think it's a fantastic thing. We need welfare, but he talks about the downfalls of welfare in terms of commons. He talks about privatization, government ownership, mutual corrosion. He talks about the welfare state. He talks about all these technical solutions, but what he says is we really need an extension in morality, and they really need another component to them because technical solutions alone do not work. So that article, that this article here, you have to read, because besides the questions that you have this week for your forum posts, you also are going to have to, there's going to be questions on your midterm exam regarding this This reading. So this reading is actually the most important reading all semester that you will have to, I guess, find time to read. So make sure that you find time to read The Tragedy of the Commons by Garrett Hardin. These other readings will help you answer these other forum posts, but this reading alone, you, for example, one of the questions asks about this Japanese or this Asian carp invasion video, you need to also include this article in there. So by just looking at this podcast and answering this question, I'm going to deduct points because you need to use Garrett Hardin in those answers. So what I mean is you can't answer these questions in a silo, meaning read one article, answer the forum post question. You need to read all of these articles to answer those questions in a proper, I guess, educated, informative way. All right, so I'm just giving you these tidbits for the first week. Hopefully, you'll be able to use them. These kind of are direct answers because I wanted to get you into used to answering initial forum posts. So these kind of come right from the PowerPoint for the forum questions. You're going to answer one of the six forum questions that are supposed. We have 36 students in this class. So if you get in early and you pick a question, you have to be one of the first six people to answer that question, then it becomes out of play. So if you are the seventh or eighth person to answer the same question, you don't receive points for that forum post. You get a zero. So it's absolutely essential that if you get in early, you pick a question you want to answer and you answer that question. And then that way you know you have. You're not the seventh, eighth, ninth person to answer the same question. There's six questions there. So if one of the questions has six people that have already answered it, then you need to find another question to answer. And I know you're all going to say to me, well, what happens if I'm writing out my answer and someone else answers it? Well, make sure you get in early and that won't be a problem. Okay? So I look forward to all of your initial posts for the introduction forum, and your initial post for Tragedy of the Commons due by Wednesday, 11:59. If you have any other questions, feel free to reach out. Thanks, and I hope you have a good day, and I look forward to everything, starting this journey with you in this course.